Good morning, children. Our exercise 3.3. The taxi charge in a city. Read the question. The taxi charge in a city consists of a fixed charge together with the charge for the distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, the charge paid is rupees 105. And for a journey of 15 km, the charge paid is rupees 155. What are the fixed charges and the charge per kilometer? How much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 km? That is our question. The taxi charge in a city consists of a fixed charge. It is given that a fixed charge. Let X be the fixed charge, right? Let X be the fixed charge. X be the fixed charge. And with the charge for the distance, fixed charge with the charge for the distance covered, for a distance of 10 km, the charge paid is rupees 105. Distance over 10 kilometer rupees. Take, let Y be the charge per kilometer. Let Y be the charge per kilometer. Then form the equation, that is X be the fixed charge plus for 1 kilometer Y charge, that is a total 10 kilometer. Distance traveled is 10 kilometer. 10Y is equal to the total amount is 105. That is our first equation. X plus 10Y is equal to 105. Let X be the fixed charge and Y be the charge per kilometer. Then distance traveled is 10 kilometer. That means fixed charge plus charge for a 10 kilometer is equal to 105. Then next sentence. Read the next question. For the journey of 15 kilometer, the charge paid is 155. For the journey of 15 kilometer, charge paid is 155. That means fixed charge plus X plus 15 kilometer, 15Y is equal to 155. The equation number 2. First one, X plus 10Y is equal to 105. Second one, X plus 15Y is equal to, next 15 kilometer, the charge paid is 155. We have two equations. Using substitution method, solve this. From 1, take the value of X. X is equal to 105 minus 10Y. This is our equation number 3. Clear? This is equation 3. Then X is equal to 105 minus 10Y. Then substituting 3 in 2. Substituting this equation from another equation, that is X plus 15Y is equal to 155. This is our second equation. That is, instead of X you write 105 minus 10Y plus 15Y is equal to 155. Instead of X you write 105 minus 10Y plus, already we have a 15Y, that is equal to 155. That is equal to 105 plus 5y is equal to, simplify the equation, 155. That is 5y is equal to 155 minus 105, that is equal to 50. Y is equal to 50 divided by 5, that is equal to 10. Y equal to 50 divided by 5 is equal to 10. This is our fourth equation, the value of y. Then substituting in 4 in 3. Substituting 4 in 3. Substituting 4 in 3. That is, instead of y, we have x is equal to, that is 3 is x is equal to 105 minus 10y. Instead of y, you write 105 minus 10 into 5. Sorry, 10 into 10. 10y value is 10. 10 into 10, that is 105 minus 100, that is equal to 5. The value of x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 10. 50 divided by 5 is 10. Then x is equal to 5 and y equal to 10. Then our question is, how much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 kilometer? Here we got the answer, our solution, x is equal to 5, and y equal to 10. We have to find how much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 kilometer. For traveling 25 kilometer, what is our equation? The fixed charge plus 25y is the fixed charge plus 25y, that is equal to, what is x? X is equal to 5 plus 25 into 10. What is the value of y? 25 into 10, that is equal to 5 plus 250, that is equal to 255. Clear? Y 5 plus 250 is equal to 255. The cost of traveling a distance of 25 kilometer is 255 rupees. This is 255 rupees. Clear? Okay, right? Okay, we pass on the next question. Read the next question. A fraction becomes 9 by 11. What is the fraction? Fraction is in the form of x by y. Clear? A fraction is of the form x by y. A fraction, given that according to your question, a fraction becomes 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both the numerator and the denominator. If 2 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it is a 9 by 11. Clear? And second data, if 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 by 6. The value changes to 5 by 6. Find the fraction. Our question, read the question once again. A fraction becomes 9 by 11. Suppose that our fraction is in the form. Fraction is in the form x by y. If 2 is added to both the numerator, according to our question, 2 is added to both the numerator and denominator, x plus 2 by y plus 2 is equal to, the fraction become 9 by 11. Okay, First condition, x plus 2 by y plus 2 is equal to 9 by 11. Reduce into linear form, cross multiply. That is 11 into x plus 2 is equal to 9 into y plus 2. 11x plus 22 is equal to 9y plus 18. Clear? Open the bracket. 11 into x plus 2 is equal to 9 into y plus 2. 11 into x, 11x plus 2 into 11, 22. Then 9 into y, 9y plus 9 into 2, 18. Then simplify, that is 11x minus 9y is equal to 18 minus 22. 18 minus 22 is a minus 4. That is our first equation. Clear? Then our first equation, x plus 2 by y plus 2 is equal to 9 by 11. Cross multiply and form in the form of a linear equation. 11x minus 9y is equal to 18 minus 22 minus 4. Then what is our second condition? If it is 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 by 6. If 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, that is 3 added, what is the relation? X plus 3 divided by y plus 3 is equal to 5 by 6. The value changes to 5 by 6. X plus 3 by y plus 3 is equal to 5 by 6. Then convert into linear form, cross multiply. 6 into x plus 3 is equal to 5 into y plus 3. 6x plus 6 into 3, 18 is equal to 5 into y, 5y plus 5 into 3, 15. That is 6x minus 5y is equal to 15 minus 18, that is minus 3. This is our second equation. First equation is 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4. Second equation, 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. Then find the value of x and y and find the fraction. This is a homework question. Homework. Do as a homework. Clear? We form two equations, 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4 and 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. This question is a homework. Okay. Next question. Read next question. This is an age problem. 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. 5 years ago, Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. What are their present age? 5 years hence, after 5 years, the age of Jacob will be 3 times his son. 5 years ago, before 5 years, that is Jacob's age was 7 times that of his son. Okay. Suppose that the present age of Jacob is X. Jacob is X. And present age of His son is a Y. You take that the present age of Jacob is X and present age of his son is a Y. Then, what is our first condition? After 5 years, 5 years hence, after 5 years, what are their age? Jacob's age become? Jacob's age is a X plus 5. And son's age? Son's age is a Y plus 5. 5 years hence, Jacob's age become X plus 5 and his son's age is a Y plus 5. Then what is our condition? 5 years hence, the age of Jacob will be three times that of his son. Three times that of his son. That is a 5 years hence, Jacob's age will be three times, that is X plus age. X plus 5 is equal to 3 times Y plus 5. The son's age is a Y plus 5. 5 years hence, his age is a 3 times a his a son's age. Clear? That is X plus 5 is equal to 3Y plus 15. X plus 5 is equal to 3Y plus 15. Then simplify, X minus 3Y is equal to 15 minus 5, that is 10. 15 minus 10. 5, that is equal to 10. That is our first condition. First equation, X minus 3Y is equal to 10. Equation 1. This is our equation 1. Okay, read the next condition. 5 years ago, Jacob's age was seven times his son's age. 5 years ago. What happened? Jacob's age is X minus 5. And son's age, Y minus 5. Jacob's age will be X minus 5 is equal to 7 times his son's age, 7 into Y minus 5, Y minus 5, 7 into Y minus 5. Then open the bracket and simplify the equation. X minus 5 is equal to 7y minus 35. That is a X minus 7y is equal to minus 35 plus 5 is a minus 30. Equation number 2. First equation is a X minus 3y is equal to 10. Second equation is a X minus 7Y is equal to minus 30. Then using substitution method, solve the equation using substitution method. From 1, that is a X minus 3Y is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 plus 3Y. This is a equation number 3. Then substitute 3 in 2. Second equation, X minus 7y is equal to X minus 7y is equal to minus 3. Substituting 3 in 2. X minus 7y is equal to minus 30. That is, instead of X, you write X is equal to 10 plus 3Y. 10 plus 3Y. X is equal to 10 plus 3Y. Okay. X 10 plus 3Y minus 7Y is equal to minus 30. That is 10 plus 3y minus 7y is equal to minus 30. That is minus 4y is equal to 3y minus 7y is a minus 4y minus 30 minus 10 minus 40. That is y is equal to minus 40 by minus 4. That is equal to 10. Y is equal to minus 40 by minus 4. That is equal to 10. Then this is our fourth equation, substituting 4 in 3. 3 is x is equal to 10 plus 3y. That is equal to 10 plus 3 into 10. That is equal to 10 plus 3 into 10. 10 plus 30. That is equal to 40. That means Jacob's age be 40 and his son's age is 10. Age of Jacob is 40 years and his son is equal to the age of his son. 40 years son is 10 years. Clear? Any doubt? Okay. First, write fast. Okay, we pass on the next topic, elimination method. Your second third method, elimination method. Third topic. First is a geometrical representation. Second one, substitution method. Third one, elimination method. That means we eliminate one variable from two equation and find the value of other variable. That is the method. In this method, one variable out of the two variable is eliminated by making the coefficient equal in one variable both equation. After the elimination of the variable, the left equation be in the form of one variable and solve this variable and again use the substitution method to find the other variable. Clear? Using elimination method, that is we eliminate one variable, that is making the coefficient in both equation equal and add or subtract to solve the equation to get one variable and find the value of that variable and substitute this variable in any one of the equation. Write one example. Solve the pair of linear equation using elimination method. That is x plus y is equal to 5 and 2x minus 3y is equal to 2x minus 3y is equal to 4. This is our equation number 1, equation number 2. Then convert the coefficient of both the equation, any one of the variable equal, making equalize in the two equation, any variable in the equal form. Here x is a coefficient is 1 and here x is the coefficient 2. Convert the coefficient of this x is 2. That means multiply the first equation by 2. Otherwise, we can make the coefficient of y. Here 3 and here 1. First one 1 and second one 3. Making equalize means convert the 2. Y coefficients are 3, that means multiply first equation by 3. Here we convert the first making the coefficient of x equal, that means multiply by 2, the equation 1 by multiply equation 1 by 2, number 2, that is multiply throughout by 2, that means 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. Multiply first equation throughout by 2, that means 2x plus 2 into x, 2x, 2 into y, 2y, and is equal to 10. This is our third equation. Then first second equation is same. Equation coefficient of x is 2 itself, so there is no need for converting. That means you write the equation 2, second equation itself, that is equation number 2 itself. There is no change. That is 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. 2x minus 3y is equal to 4. Then if you add and or subtract, eliminate any one of the coefficient. Here we subtract this equation, that is first equation 1 minus 2, equation 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 means what is the process? Of change the sign and add. Plus become minus, minus become plus, and add. 2x minus 2x is 0x, that means this x coefficient is a eliminator. Plus 5y is equal to 2y plus 3y is equal to 5y is equal to 10 minus 4 is 6. What is the value of y? This equation become a variable, one variable, 5y is equal to 6, that means y is equal to 6 by 5. Equation number 4. Y equal to 6 by 5. Substituting in equation the value of 4, substituting, then again use the substitution method, substitute 4 in any one of the equation, equation 1 or 2 or in 3. Substitute the value of y in any of this equation. We substitute here, substitute the value in 1. So equation 4 in 1, that is instead of y you write 6 by 5. X plus 6 by 5 is equal to 5. That is x is equal to 5 minus 6 by 5, taking the LCM, LCM is 5, that is 25 minus 6, that is equal to 19 divided by 5. That means x is equal to 19 by 5 and y equal to 6 by 5. This is the third method, elimination method, that we eliminate any one of the variable x or y and convert the equation in one variable and find the variable value and substitute this value to the other equation. That is the method, simple method. Okay, that means x is equal to 19 by 5 and y equal to 6 by 5. That is our solution. This is the simple question. Take next section. Okay, exercise 3.4. Solve the pair of linear equation by elimination method. First question already done, x plus y is equal to 5 and 2x minus 3y equal to 4. Then your homework question is 2 and 3. Homework is 2 and 3. Remember, we eliminate the equation, there is no variable, that means it has an infinite number of solution. We eliminate this equation, there is no variable, that means it has an infinite number of solution. 3.4, question number 1, subpart, question 2 and 3, homework. Clear? Okay. Thank you.